Ladies and gentlemen, I am very honored to be with you today to discuss such important subjects, to participate in this conference dedicated to the development of human rights. And I will present a few remarks on the development of human rights, and probably I will present also some my remarks on that subject, and after that we could discuss, you could pose the questions, we could exchange views in these problems, which is of the greatest importance today. First of all, I have to mention that the most important source and basis of the contemporary international law is the Charter of the United Nations. And this, by the Charter of the United Nations, some of the basic human rights was codified and also became the basis, ground basis for the further development in the aim of the improvement of the human beings, of the humanity in the world, and also as other principles of the Charter of the United Nations, as the maintaining on develop peace and development of the friendly relations among peoples, among nations, among countries. The development of human rights is also of the most important aims created, scheduled by the Charter of the United Nations. 3 years later, in the 1948, it was adopted the Universal Declaration of Human Rights. This declaration was one attempt to codify the human rights on the international level. But having in mind the legal nature of this document, it was not an document of the international, of the source of international law in the stricto sensu interpretation. Because Universal Declaration, it is a declaration. The legal nature of the document is not international treaty which has the obligatory force for all countries who adopted it. But it is a declaration of aims, of values, of the human humanity, which is to be achieved in the future. And after that, after the adoption of Universal Declaration, it was scheduled one process for creation of the one more important document, one treaty international, which be universally obliged. Treaty of Human Rights adopted by great majority of nations, of states, but the development after the Second World War has not resulted in this way by such, but by adoption of such document. And instead of that, it was adopted the pacts of political and social rights, and another pact of the economical, social, and cultural rights. Two documents, those two documents are legal sources of international human rights. And after that, the development of international human rights had more inconsistency, probably sometimes contradiction. And it is obvious that the this process had not one general universal direction. Instead of the in the and it was accepted on the regional levels, declarations of human rights, conventions on human rights, European Convention on Human Rights by the Council of Europe, on also African African Convention of Human Rights, Inter-American System of Human Rights, and even but also is very important to see that in that period of time the human rights became the parts of the national constitutions, of the national legal systems in all countries in the world. And it is very important, but in same time, this present one situation of the fragmentary development of human rights instead of universal development by the creation, universal institution, instruments, sources, and also organ authorities who will protect it. And the most important achievement in this field is obviously the creation of the European Court of Human Rights here in Strasbourg, by the creation of that court, the ordinary citizen obtained the right to protest against own state, to start one proceeding, to accuse own state, and to realize some rights which was neglected, rejected to the person in that country. And the proceeding in this court is very very well developed, without less formalities, and this produced the increasing number of such cases in the Court of Human Rights in Strasbourg. Now it is the more than 100,000 of plans against some states from the East, but also from the West of Europe, among the members of this Council of Europe, for those countries is competent and obliged them to accept the decisions of the European Court of Human Rights. Also, one inconsistency in the development of human rights during the last 70 years of the after the Second World War, we can see in the policy of different states in the internal levels. We have different in the more developed states, better protection of human rights. In less developed states, contrary, less development of human rights. No such level of protection, but also on the international level is also one problem of the existence of various bodies of protection of human rights, and also many countries accepted some conventions, other rejected or accepted with reservation, treaty reservation, to be abolished of some responsibilities in own countries, and that is one reality. But for the development of human rights, particularly for younger generation, in the essence, it is also very important to see that distribution of sources In the economic sense, distribution of possibilities, of chance for development, for education, for other rights, benefits, other benefits, is existing, even increasing. And in one country we have a very young, poor generation in some suburbs about which the professor discussed, presented some cases, many cases. And also we have the part of population who profit, benefit more rich opportunities for education, for other personal developments. And on the international level, we have seen the different policies on international relations. Sometimes international communities demand or impose to some countries such respect of human rights for individuals and condemn them, accuse them for non-respect of human rights. But in same times, for non-respect of human rights, the approach of international community is completely different. I am coming from Serbia. As you know, the Kosovo intervention against Serbia, Yugoslavia, former Yugoslavia, was realized contrary to the Charter of United Nations. And it was one so-called humanitarian intervention to protect human rights and to stop the national ethnic cleansing or massacres of some one national minority in south province of Serbia, Kosovo. And the intervention of NATO was realized without authorization of the United Nations. After that, when the NATO troops arrived to Kosovo, the national minority of Kosovo Albanians started even more cruel atrocities, ethnic cleansings of province of Kosovo from the Serbian population and non-Albanian, other non-Albanian, even against the Albanians who did not accept new local government. And international community, we have seen one report of Dick Marty, the parliamentarian of the Council of Europe Parliament, who presented a special report about human organ trafficking, realized during the NATO and after the NATO intervention on Kosovo. And international community rejected to accept that a special investigation should be realized under the supervision of the United Nations. Diplomats from more important countries, from French, Great Britain, American, German, everybody rejected such demand of Serbian government that such investigation must be realized, and the person who realized such crimes be punished. And also that is the problem in the international community, such double standards approach. And it is politically more and more sensitive. All international community has to accept on the same manner, on same rules, and accept to the common efforts to develop and to improve human rights in the whole world. And even more, to accept the necessity of more human redistribution of the wealth of natural wealths, and in order to create one more harmonious and happiest world. That it was some brief remarks, and now I am ready to give the answers on your questions.